नमस्कार एंड वेलकम टू राग परिचय. वी विजिट राग भूपाल तोड़ी टुडे. यू नो लास्ट वीक वी लुक्ड एट राग गुजरी तोड़ी विच वाज अ डेरिवेटिव ऑफ द तोड़ी राग और द तोड़ी मेन राग. गुजरी तोड़ी वाज ऑब्टेन्ड बाय ओमिटिंग वन नोट. सो गुजरी तोड़ी हैड सिक्स नोट्स. इट ओमिटेड द पंचम कंप्लीटली. To arrive at a pentatonic derivative of the main todi rag, we have to omit two notes. So in addition to the pancham, if we omit the shuddha nishad, then what we get is this derivative, a pentatonic derivative of todi. This is rag chhaya todi, but this didn't really become very popular. What became a bit more popular or acceptable was another derivative of todi, which retained the pancham but then omitted the madhyam and the nishad completely. So sare ga pa, so we retain the pa and the dhaivat and omit the nishad and the pancham. What we get then is Bhupal Todi. This became a bit more popular. But again, as we have known so far, this is just a scale. And that doesn't make a rag. What makes a rag is the chalan of a rag. So let's go on to look at the chalan of Bhupal Todi. Bhupal Todi is also known as Bhupala. And the name Bhupal probably came from the fact that it has the scale sare ga pa da sa, which is the same scale as Bhupali. So when we start looking at the chalan of Bhupal Todi, we realize it's not very complex at all. It of course retains the Todi raganga, which is, as we've seen earlier, which is just contained within the sa re ga. I mean, the peculiar way in which the sa re ga is rendered defines todi. Defined positions of the swara re and the ga. Now we've seen that the gandhar is trying to meet up with the pancham. It has the sharja gandhar relationship with the pancham, and so there is also this sharja gandhar relationship between the dhaivat and the sa. Which is a part of todi. So Bhupal Todi retains this, and so everything remains the same. Da da sa Nishad is omitted, but we retain the dhasa relation. So story continues. And we have the Pancham. In case of Gujri Todi, because of the Pancham omitted, the Komal Gandhar lost a bit of its sheen and the Komal Rishabh became popular, more prominent. Now here, the Pancham is back again, so the Gandhar gets back its original position as like Todi. So, and the Pancham, which was weak in the Todi, in the main Todi, Miyaki Todi, becomes a prominent note here because that's the only thing there. There is no Tivra Madhya. And the route to Komal Dhaivat now goes through the Pancham and not the Tivra Madhyam like in Todi. And then, of course, the route to Sa is straight from the Daivat. There is no Nishad out there. So over the entire range, absolute Todi. So, Bhupal Todi is really a very, very simple rag. But then the rag is the most truncated version of the Todi. And it doesn't really offer so many melodious sub-phrases. And probably for that reason, didn't become very popular for use in light music, you know. So you won't find many songs based on rag Bhupal Todi. Bhupal Todi becomes a bit more prominent because this then is the gateway to rag Bilas Khani Todi, which we are going to see in the next episode. Let's go on to listen to a bandish in Bhupal Todi, bandish in Madhyalay Teen Taal.
Oh, no.